Well, he's one of history's favorite villains from Terminator 2. Decades later, Robert Patrick is as busy as ever with a TV show and a movie coming out. Welcome, Robert Patrick. How are you?
Wonderful, wonderful.
So good to have you.
It's great to be here. It's great to see you again.
So good. Okay, you guys all remember him from Terminator, right?
Of course.
So I've always talked about, like, sometimes I film at my house. One day I walk down the stairs, I literally bump right into Robert. I went, like, the nicest, coolest, you know how you can tell but how they treat kids?
Yes.
And
yes.
He was so lovely and sweet to my son. I just have to tell you that because I just love you ever since that day.
What did you say to me? Am I targeted for termination or something?
I don't know.
She couldn't help herself.
I just scared her a little bit. Yeah, we had a great episode in your
house. Was Scorpion you
shot. Bobby Roth directed it. Scorpion, I think that was our first season.
Right.
And
did you know you'd go on to four?
Yeah, I had a good feeling about the show from the get-go. As a matter of fact, as soon as I looked at the cover page, and it's turned into such a wonderful comedy. At first, I thought it was a drama. I signed on, we were going to do a 1 hour drama about a federal agent with a team of geniuses, but it's become such a comedy, so I'm having a lot of fun doing it.
Well, and it's really grueling, though, because I was talking to you earlier, 8 months out of the year, 12-hour days.
Yeah.
On top of that, you just did a movie that we're going to talk about, too. How do you keep, and you're really, you know, like a family man, how do you keep up such a devoted, I mean, a grueling schedule?
Just keep going. Just keep moving forward, one foot in front of the other. Get going with it, you know?
Right.
I love doing it. I'm so blessed to be able to do what I do for a living. And I just want to cram in as much as I can before it's over, you know? So I'm constantly seeking new material and looking for things to do. I'm blessed by the opportunity to be doing Scorpion. And when this hiatus popped up and I got a script like Last Rampage showed up, I was like, it's the complete juxtaposition, opposite of what I do. I'm such a salt of the earth guy. And Gary Tyson is just an absolute devil. And it's a true story. He's just one of the most awful human beings I've ever run across.
Well, let's look first at a clip of Scorpion, and then we're going to see your Last Rampage. Here's Scorpion.
As everybody knows, Walter's integrity is far too high to only be interested in the carnal, so it's...
Is he having a seizure?
He got juiced. He's got a stun cuff on his ankle. It pops anytime he gets too far away from the one that's locked onto my own leg. Or if he gets too lippy. And that, my friend, was for disrespecting Paige.
Point taken.
I'm in.
Yeah.
I love it.
Nicely
fun
done.
Fun show.
Yeah. I'm in.
We have a lot of fun. Great Cat McPhee there.
Right.
So we got a great cast. We got Ari Stidham, Ellie Scabell, Eddie K. Thomas, Jaden Wong. We're having a good time.
Okay, I do want to talk about The Last Rampage. Will you set this up for us exactly? Because it's a real-life story of what happened.
True story, 1978, which was one of the reasons I wanted to do it. It's such an interesting period piece. A man escapes from prison in Arizona with the help of his three teenage boys. Heather Graham is my wife. She and I have created this mythology about me that I'm, you know, not really as bad as they think I am, even though I'm serving a double life sentence in prison. We do a broad daylight escape. Of course, there's no cell phones, there's no way to track us. We're rolling around in Arizona, and seven people unfortunately cross my path, and I kill them all, including an infant. It's the darkest guy I've ever played. For me as an artist, I feel it's important to present that to people, to really study them and see how did they end up like this.
Right.
And Dwight Little did a fantastic job directing the film. And it really does transport you. I think it just overwhelms you when you see the movie. You're transported in 1978.
Let's take a look at a clip. It's getting rave reviews, by the way. Here's a clip of Last Rampage.
Here's what we're going to do. We're going to keep our heads about us, just like the radio says, and Uncle Joe's going to get that plane here, and we're going to be in Mexico free and clear. And if he is a day late and we got some time, there's this little bank I'm thinking we might ought to hit.
There you go.
Casinos use it, and the cash piles up like you couldn't imagine.
Sure, that's a good idea. And you being a fugitive and us never robbing a bank.
How much money you got in your pockets?
Not much.
Come on, give me a number. Open up your pockets.
About eight.
So you think you're gonna run this thing on $8 and 2 bits? You need to sit back and let the captain steer the ship.
Doesn't get any better than that. Yeah. Honestly, so good.
That's my oldest boy, Alex McNichol.
In the show.
And he does a fantastic job. We got Bruce Davison, Chris Browning and the late, great John Hurd.
I was just going to ask you about that.
Sorry.
I'm sorry. I didn't interrupt you, but I was going to ask you if that's tough because John Hurd passed away and this was one of his last projects. As you see this, is it difficult to kind of watch knowing that?
Yeah, and I'm also very grateful that I stuck around to watch him shoot the scene with Bruce Davison, too. Unbelievably talented men, and to see the scene that they shot together, I'm just really glad I stuck around to watch him. And I had dinner with him that night, and you know, I'm glad for the time spent with him. So grateful he did the movie.
And you get to spend you are able to spend a lot of time with your family. I know you're very, very devoted to your family. Do you get to still spend a lot of time with them, even with this pretty difficult schedule?
Yeah, the great thing about doing Scorpion, we're in L.A., so it's a you know, dream come true job, you know, working in L.A. And
you can go home at night.
And I go home at night, sleep with my wife, see my kids. I got one that's away at college. I got one that's still in high school. So it's fantastic for me right now. My hiatus is due. I saw you at the Rams game.
Oh, yeah.
You got better season tickets
than me. How'd that happen?
Score that.
You know, and it was great because I did go and I looked and Pena. Why am I totally?
Michael Pena.
Michael Pena was like right behind me.
Yeah.
And I'm like, don't worry, I won't blow your cover.
Oh, I was texting him. I was. We did Gangster Squad together. So I was looking at all you guys in the game.
Anytime you want to come sit in my seat,
yeah.
I'll be happy.
Yeah. Rub it in.
No.
They looked good last night, right?
Yes, they did. I was excited. But thank you.
Robert, we love you. Thank you for coming in.
Absolutely,
you're such a good guy.
Thank you.
All right. Well, okay. The last Rampage is playing now at the Lemley Music Hall in Beverly Hills. And the new season of Scorpion premieres Monday, September 25th. At 10 p.m. on CBS. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Robert.
Thank you so
Always
much.
Always a pleasure. Coming up, want to dress your child like